At Waitangi, the government's opponents have been encouraged to stand and fight against any proposals to change the treaty. The call came as Labor and Green MPs are welcomed onto treaty grounds. Our team is in Waitangi, and in a moment, Te Anua Hurahanganui has details of another legal challenge to government plans. But first, Deputy Political Editor Mikey Sherman on the challenge for politicians.
Labor and the Greens receiving a powerful welcome at Waitangi. But while the ceremonial challenges were laid down, the real call to action was to stand together against the government. The treaty debate has drawn clear battle lines.
Stop using Māori to undermine our mana and to uphold your racist political kōrero.
Opposition parties today vowing to stand alongside Māori and fight.
If you want to know why kids aren't attending school regularly, perhaps we could start by asking some of them.
We've had an extraordinary couple of years, you know, huge disruption, but I don't think labelling parents, and particularly singling out Māori parents, is the way of re-engaging those kids in education.
Jacinda Ardern's departure has certainly created a vacuum on the left, and Greens co-leader hopeful Chloe Swarbrick's vowing to overtake Labor as the main opposition party.
We are staking a claim to be the strongest on the aspirations that we have always had, Mikey. That hasn't changed, that isn't new. We always...
What is new, though, is that there's a direct threat to Labor there.
Oh, that's always been there.
My main opponent is not the Green Party, it's the National Party and the ACT Party and New Zealand First.
We asked around at the Kirikiri markets whether a new leader will make the Greens stronger than Labor.
You've got one side is, old and they've been in there for a while, and then the other side is young.
I do like Chloe.
Definitely think the Greens, now that Chloe's in the running, will make a change.
I mean, if you could morph the two of them together, it would be fantastic.
Plenty for the two parties to consider as they weigh up who the real enemy is.
Mikey's with us in Waitangi tonight. Kia ora, Mikey. Some strong words in those speeches today. What more can you tell us?
Certainly. Well, with the treaty debate being so fiery, it should come as no surprise that a lot of the whai kōrero and speeches are equally as fiery. Today we heard the word enemy being thrown around quite a bit. The government was referred to as a spider, and Labour MP Penny Henare used a metaphor whereby he spoke of raising a gun and firing off a shot. Now, while some will be alarmed at that and question whether it is unhelpful in this debate, it should also be remembered that whai kōrero in te ao Māori is viewed as an art form, and the use of metaphors often depicts the level of skill of the orator. Those metaphors should not be taken literally, and Penny Henare is a renowned speaker in te ao Māori. As for the opposition parties, they have clearly heard the call of Māori to stand alongside them, and they have taken up that challenge. They do risk distracting themselves, though, by fighting with each other. Labour and the Greens scrapping it out over who the main opposition party really is. A word of warning, focus on the government.
Tēnā koe, Mikey. Thank you.